how's the common library?
Tomorrow, I should be able to have it.
Tomorrow.
And he didn't know if he'd be here tonight. Oh, in the morning?
Yeah, he's taking her up tonight, because he's gonna be there at six.
He was waiting till 2 o'clock this afternoon to hear what the...
We gotta help. Okay, it is 6 o'clock, so I'd ask that you stand and join me in the pledge of allegiance, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic over which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Would you call the roll, please?
Kalinowski?
Here.
Ball? Here. Walker?
Here.
Cruz?
Here.
Pachinski?
Here.
Okay, on the meeting agenda for tonight, under communications and announcements, we have item A, the Manistee County Trail Committee meeting minutes from March 12th and April 9th. Item B is the Manistee County Planning Commission meeting schedule letter for 2018. Item C is the MRA baseball registration notification. D is the garlic mustard work bee and lunch at Lagoon Creek announcement for that. And that work bee is scheduled for May 18th. And under presentations, we have item A, Great Lakes Assessing Presentation. Department and committee reports. Item A is the water department report you have in your packet from Wade Trim. B is the zoning administrator's report. C, the planning commission meeting minutes. D, zoning board of appeals. E, building and grounds committee minutes. F is the board of review. G, PEG commission. H, DDA meeting minutes. I, personnel committee. J is the regional resource recovery project. K, the sewer project. L is the fire department report. M is the elections commission. Under new business, we have item A, consideration of approval of various signage for Township Hall and the Nelson Street office in the amount of $1,656 from Amore Sign Studios. Item B is consideration of approval of four private property signs for Lagoon and Sunday Parks in the amount of $496 from Amore Sign Studios. C is consideration of approval of a bid for a new furnace at the fire department. Item D is consideration of approval of the Charter Township of Filer Township Principal Residence Exemption, PRE, the denial interest summary policy. And we have item E, the addendum item is consideration of approval of the sewer project draw number four, in the amount of $237,000. And if there are no additions or deletions to that meeting agenda, I would entertain a motion for approval.
I'll make the motion.
I'll second.
Okay, we have a motion by Kalinowski, support by Pachinski to approve the meeting agenda. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The motion carried. On the consent agenda for tonight, we have item A, the minutes of the regular board meeting held April 3rd. B is approval of the Township General Fund expenditures, including the fire department. Those checks are number 35480 through 35559. Accounts payable total $36,617.64. Payroll totals $12,325.41, bringing the total to $48,943.05. Item C is approval of sewer construction expenditures. Those checks are numbered 130 and 131, totaling $405,000. Item D is approval of water department expenditures. Those are checks number 2463 through 2471 totaling $32,444.36. Item E is approval for the township clerk to attend the clerk's summer conference in June in Traverse City at a cost of $400 plus accommodations. Item F is approval for the Manistee Lions Club to hold their annual white cane sale on May 4th, 2018 at various locations in the township. Again, if there are no additions or deletions to the consent agenda, I will entertain a motion for approval. Motion by Brian Cruz, support by Hachinsky to approve the consent agenda. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Okay, if we move right to our presentation. We have Sharon here from Great Lakes Assessing to give us information on some more requirements.
This is hopefully the last piece of the puzzle that we will need to be in compliance with our AMAR review, which Terry just got the letter. They will be knocking on our door, wanting us to send the database soon. And what this does is it is a resolution by the township stating that the Manistee County Treasurer, who does your PRE audits, can bill the entities and also can issue checks to the state of Michigan so that they get their cut and their interest. And that's basically what this is all about. They want to make sure that they are getting their fair share in the PRE audits, because the people pay penalties and interest, and it's kind of going into the general fund of the county and may not necessarily be taking the next step. When Molly had a meeting with the county treasurer, I believe there was two PREs and filer that she had denied. And I believe those checks, if they haven't been cut, will be cut shortly. So by the time we have our AMARs, we'll have the proof that they have paid them. But all this resolution is you guys just saying, okay, county, you can pay the state for the interest. And you do get a small amount. I don't know if they actually are spreading that quite the way it should be spread, but there you go. I think now she probably will be, since it's been brought to her attention that the state's going to be looking at it. Any questions? And this will put us in pretty good shape, I think, for the AMAR. We've been working on it, and you guys have passed some other resolutions and stuff, so we should slide right through, hopefully.
Do you know when that would be, Sharon?
With Terry getting the letter, I imagine in the next couple weeks they'll be calling and wanting our database, and then it's usually 2 to 3 weeks after that when they set up the meetings. And I would really highly recommend that Terry goes along with Molly to that meeting, because it's kind of eye-opening.
Yeah, if they don't give it a date.
Yeah.
They just said they will contact.
Usually it's a couple weeks after those letters go out.
Will it be here in town?
Yeah, they'll meet us at the, usually they do it at the county courthouse somewhere, and I'm going to assume they have a room over there. So, yeah.
Okay.
Any other questions? Okay.
All right, thank you.
Yeah.
Enjoy the rest of your evening.
Oh, we will.
Okay. Under Department and Committee Reports, item A, you have the report in your packet for the Water Department. Also included, you have Larry's report. Oh, I did. I am sorry. Dale, Jim, forgive me. I forgot public comment. That slid right out by. Public comment. No, okay. Okay, so item C, the Planning Commission, again, you have the meeting minutes in your packet for that. And ZBA, Building and Grounds did not meet last month, so there are no meeting minutes there, nor Board of Review. PEG Commission, you've got the report in your packet. Keith, anything you want to add to written report?
We had a power outage. I think the whole city did. I'm not sure if fire was involved in that. But when the power came back on, it blew up the server, which is a $10,000 piece of equipment. But fortunately, we had a spare that had gone down before, and I repaired it. It was just sitting there. So I spent the weekend hooking that up. And so we got back on the air, albeit with a few caveats, but we'll still work it out. Other than that, everything's fine.
H, you have the DDA minutes in your packet. I, the Personnel Committee, did not meet, but they will be meeting this week, Thursday. And Regional Resource Recovery, those minutes are in your packet. Should have attended that? Did you?
I didn't. That was the last day of the conference. That should have been their last meeting.
Okay.
So we'll have to see what the minutes of that read when we get them.
Okay. Kay, the sewer project, just to give you a quick update, you've probably seen Elmer's equipment situated along 31. They have finished the force main from 31 to the lift station. The lift station is completed as far as the three manholes goes. The valves have not been installed, nor the actual pump. That'll be coming. They have started now with the main running on the west side of 31, starting at where they left off last fall. Today they bored and jacked under Care Center Drive. They got that done, and they'll continue to go south. So you'll see them working.
The east side.
East. What did I say?
West. East side.
Yeah, east side. I'm sorry.
West would have been the good side.
Yeah.
A long way to make them fight.
Yeah, the east side. They, like I say, they did. Actually, I went by this morning on my way out to Reamers at about 8, it was about 7:15. I went by there. They weren't working yet, but I saw the equipment there, and then they actually finished that. They started that and finished that today, and they will continue now. Brian told me as they go south, you will see the, what do you want to call it, that they'll dig the
safety.
Not the tunnel, but
the safety bar.
Yeah, they'll have safety equipment there that prevents cave-ins and that, because they're actually going to be in portions there because of the slope of the highway. They're going to be pretty deep. Actually, at one point, they'll be down to 22 feet. So they don't have to have a real wide trench, you know, and keep their trench narrow that way. By the time they get to the south end, then they'll be back at an elevation that would be more typical of sewer mains at about 8 feet deep.
Are they going to go under the blacktop? Because they tore up the Care Center guy.
Yeah.
It's ripped right up.
Did they tear it up?
Yep.
They piled it at the same spot where you tore up the blacktop.
No, I was told they were born in Jacksonville.
Yeah, it didn't work.
This car, this car, they went through it.
Huh. So I didn't, well, I guess I came home the other way. I didn't want to, when I came by.
But they're going to try to go underneath all the others.
Yeah. they were supposed to do there.
And they tore up piles of blacktops in there. Well, sand piles out of their sands.
Well, it, you know, they did say some they may have to, but when they do, they're going to do half at a time. You know, for particularly the business entries, so that they're not messing up their entry to their business. I guess that's about all I've got to report there. Fire department report, Jim?
Yes, sir. We had a busy month. We had 35 calls for service, 28 medicals, 6 fires, 4 of which were mutual aids to either the city or strike, 1 grass fire, 1 vehicle crash. We had 4 calls to Horizon Point, which gives us a total for the year so far of 115. To break that 115 down just a little bit, it's it broke down to 95 rescue runs, 16 fires, 3 traffic crashes, 1 gas complaint, and a total of 29 runs so far to Horizon Point with 5 automatic mutual aids so far this year with, like I said, between the city and Stronic. The annual maintenance on our fire apparatus has begun. They started yesterday. They came in and they worked on 123 in our engine. And so he'll be here probably most of the week because they're doing all of the trucks, the engine, the tanker, the rescue, brush truck, and the utility trucks. And they're going to do them all. So he's predicted to be done by Thursday afternoon sometime. So, so if you see activity over there, the door's open. That's what he's doing. Doing maintenance. Painting on the inside is ongoing as time permits. The weather's getting nice. We were out last night. We pumped some water. We worked on the truck and we had some issues with the primer and stuff on that. So we took the truck out last night. We pumped a lot of gallons of water through it just to make sure that what he repaired was actually working correctly. So that proved to be true. He did a nice job of fixing the truck and again under new business we have a heating and air conditioning unit that went down that's been fixed multiple times and I would recommend that we look at replacing it rather than there's 2 quotes from custom that have one was for repair one was for replace. I would not recommend that we repair it again. The heat exchanger is cracked. In order to replace that, majority of that cost to repair that is going to be labor. You've got to basically tear the entire unit apart in order to replace that heat exchanger. So I would recommend that we look at replacing that unit. It's 15 plus years old. It was put in back when we did the renovation back in 2003. So,
is that on the roof right now?
It's not. It's on the ground behind the station by door 3.
Is this going to be better to put it up on the roof?
This is. It's not going on the roof. This is it's a roof unit that goes on a cement slab in the back behind a building, from the way I understand it being replaced. So I don't know where they put it on the roof.
Same size unit?
I thought it said roof mount.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
That's not my understanding, but maybe it is. Cooling rooftop unit. It's a rooftop unit, but I don't know that it's going to go on the roof. That would be something that we have to clarify. I thought it was going where the existing one is.
Well, I'm more for that. I'm rather for that than up on the roof.
I would prefer it on the ground than on the roof, too. Ease of maintenance and that type of thing on you know, we keep an eye on when we come and go, and we keep an eye on the unit itself. But anyway, again, I would recommend that we look at replacing it. So.
Same size unit that's in there, and a 7.5-ton unit?
I believe that's what's in there now. And the only thing that's air-conditioned in the fire station right now is the meeting room and the kitchen and the offices. The truck bays are not air-conditioned. And it's a separate heating unit from... The heating unit heats the meeting room, the offices, the bathroom, the kitchen area. The 2 truck bays that are attached directly to the meeting room don't have heat in them at all. And the large truck bay that we put up back in 2003 has separate gas radiant heat tubes running throughout the building, so.
That's sufficient heat for the bays, for the winter?
The truck, the large truck bay heat works great. We have to turn it right down. In wintertime, we turn it down to 65, and it maintains a nice temperature in there, and they don't work that hard when they are running, so. There's about six tubes, I think, that run throughout the building that heat that building, so. And it's great because it's a bug, and when the weather's bad, it dries, it helps dry the trucks out. Stuff when they're wet, from the wet winter weather, so. So we don't touch that, the truck bay heat. We just have to deal with that heating unit that's behind the building right now, so.
Jim, do you know who put that, the furnaces in there now, who put that in?
I don't know, because it was put in when they redid the building. So it was part of the contract price, so whoever the contractor was back then, I believe. I don't know that it was custom or not. There's a new company in town, the Jerry O'Brien, Ryan's Heating, put in a bid. So he's a little more expensive, but right now, I think the unit that he is proposing is a little bit better than Train that we currently have now. And what Custom is offering is a little bit more money, but I think it's a better unit. And I know for a fact that particular unit is meets all of the current codes and standards, and I don't know about the other one, the Train. I don't know if that's just a replacement unit or if it's top of the line, state of the art. I don't know what that is. But Jerry O'Brien is the contractor, and he's also the captain or the lieutenant on our fire department, so, and he has his own business, so that would be something to consider also.
I do have the records on that renovation.
You
need to know that I can
look
that up.
Okay.
Are there any questions for me?
Okay.
Right here, season is starting, so right now, currently, there are no burn permits being issued anywhere in the five counties that are in our area here. There shouldn't be any burning going on.
Okay, Young Elections Commission, do you have anything, Shirley?
I do not.
Moving to new business then, we have item A, consideration of approval of various signage for the Township Hall and the Nelson Street office in the amount of $1,656 from Amos Sign Studios, and you've got those quotes in your packet. Obviously, some of those signs are for the Nelson Street office building. The sign out front, which is $899. And then there are eight signs to be located inside the building for the offices, restroom, etc. Those have to be ADA compliant. So we initially had bids a little bit lower, but they were not ADA compliant signs. These are the raised lettering and the braille. And those are a total of $757. And also included is, because of the moves that are taking place, changing that sign from supervisor to treasurer, and then the sign outside Shirley and Tom's office right now says clerk / treasurer will be changed to just clerk. There's also a sign proposed for outside Tammy's office, which I think we're probably going to look at changing that a little bit. I think it says Secretary, Water and Sewer Department. I think we want that to say Water and Sewer Billing. This is not the Water Department or the Sewer Department. This is for the billing purposes. So those are the signs. Cover the two buildings.
And where would these be going? What kind of property do you want?
Oh, that's a different.
Bundling Park, yeah.
That's.
Well, I think, you know, we ran into this some years ago. Worded like this, private property beyond this point. It almost seems to me like we have to not say that, but have to say something like public property ends here or something.
Yeah, I ran that one by Richard.
What did he say?
I think that's what he came up with. I run it by him again.
Okay, it was a number of years ago.
Yeah, yeah. And this is, this says for Lagoon and Sunland. This is really, we're only talking about Sunland. And that's proposing four signs. Bob is dealing with, I forget her name, at Amor's on these and felt that we might need as many as four signs. I don't think we do. I really think we can cover it with one, maybe two at the most. The issues have been, you know, people evidently not realizing that, that it's private, beyond a certain point, taking lawn chairs and whatnot down the beach and putting them down on private property, and some of the landowners are, you know, objecting to that, so.
Have we got a lot of complaints on that, for that, off of Sunland Park?
Over the years.
Years ago we did, I know.
Yeah.
Recently, nothing.
Yeah, we have had.
Mostly in the summer, don't we?
Yeah, I want to say last summer, we had a complaint on that, and then I know shortly after I came into office, someone came in and they were complaining about the same thing.
That's because I went by the sign form, because I told them that it's not up to the township to post
right.
their property.
Right. Right.
And that was the issue that we ran into before.
Right. And that's what I told them basically the first time.
It's not the township's responsibility to post their property, private property. Our property that the township owns is public property.
Right.
If they don't want people on the beach, it's up to them to post that as private property. Why should that be a township expense to post? I mean, if I own property, are you going to post it? There's no money allowed.
Well, right, and that's why that's what I just told them.
Yeah.
It says private property beyond this point. I think if we put anything there, it has to be worded differently. Yeah.
Well,
it has to be worded something like public property ends here or something.
Or township property ends here,
right.
Something like that nature that has to do, that's affiliated with the township, not posting private property for private individuals' property.
Right. And that's why I did contact Richard.
It was a number of years ago.
On the sign. And I'll get back to him again and clarify that wording.
I agree. Why should we post their property?
Yeah,
that was the issue that we ran into before, and I think Richard was in agreement with me when they were in here complaining about that, because there are people going on to their so-called their beach. Well, that's a whole other gray area with that. Which how much of that beach is theirs actually is because they don't own up to the water. Okay, they own up to the water line, and that water line changes. And so where you put those signs is critical, and I'm not sure that you want to get involved in that. But that's
and then there's, I see there's a proposed bill, and I don't know if it's the House, that they're looking at even changing that state law that has existed for how many years about private ownership of the beach up to the high water mark. So I don't know what's going to happen with that. So I'll run this by Richard again. I know the first time they came in and complained about it, that's basically what I told them is, you know, if you don't want people trespassing in the property, post it. The people on the north side of Sunland did put a sign up. You know, I told them you have every right to do that there. I think the problem was the person that I was speaking with at that time didn't own the property adjacent to something. They were down two or three, you know, lots. And so, you know, I said, well, get together with the other property owners. But, and I agree, you know, that we've got to watch how we deal with the private property owners posting their property forms. So. But anyway, those are the proposals that we have from the new one. And we do need the ones for the Nelson Street office building and the changes of the signs here.
We didn't get any other bids, right?
No, we did not.
Open for a motion on that, sir?
Open for a motion of any kind, if
yeah, well. I'll make a motion that we spend the $899 and take over the signage for Sunland Park.
Well, what about the commercial sign?
$1,600.
You've got two items on here.
Yeah, the $899, Tom, is for the sign out in front of the office building. That
oh, and then the other one is
gives the address and tells what offices are housed there.
I saw the 16, but I thought that was the total for this year.
$1,656 is the total for the...
Is that a total for all the signage at the Nelson office and this office?
Right, that's the motion.
Okay.
I'll second it.
Okay, we have a motion on the floor for approving the $1,656 for the signage at the Nelson Street office building in the Township Hall.
Would you call who seconded that since Dale and I spoke at the same time?
Okay, motion by Kaczynski, support by Ball.
You're Ball and call him up.
Discussion. And like I said, I...
With those changes.
Yeah, I do want to talk to them about changing the outside Danny's office to water and sewer building. Secretary and water slash sewer building.
When we have tax collection, where do I want to do that? Here?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then okay. The treasurer sign on there.
Not going to need a counter or nothing, put in there. No.
It could work. A counter could work. With a hole in the wall.
You never decided on the name of that building?
It's Nelson Street Office.
So we're going to need another sign for that? Another $1 million sign for that?
No. The sign up front, I think, is all we need. Yeah, it is.
Right. Must be made a bit old.
Any other discussion? Okay, Shirley, you want to call the roll, please?
Kalinowski?
Yes.
Cruz?
Yes.
Walker?
Yes.
Ball? Yes. Kaczynski?
Yes.
Okay, then we have the proposal for the sign at some in part, and we've already had some discussion on that, so I would entertain a motion.
Motion to table.
Yeah, I'll second that.
Okay, we have a motion by Brian Cruz, support by Kaczynski to table the signage at Sunland Park. And I will have another conversation with Mr. Wilson about that. See what he's got to say. Okay, item.
Do we have a vote on that?
Oh, yes, I'm sorry, we do need to vote on that, yes. All those in favor of the motion on the floor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Item C is consideration of approval of bid for new furnace at the fire department. And again, you've got actually three proposals there, two from Custom Sheet Metal, one for repair and one for replacement. And then one bid from O'Brien's heating and cooling.
And the O'Brien thing is, I just texted Jerry, he did say that the intent on his proposal was to put it in the same location as the current unit is, not on the roof.
And, you know, as a board, you can choose to act on this tonight, or you can choose to table it, let the Building and Grounds Committee, which meets Thursday this week, take a look at these bids and make a recommendation. I'm assuming, Jim, that heat's not an issue or not going to be an issue right now for the coming weeks. And I think these just came in the end of last week, so.
Well, it would be nice to get this clarified. If a custom says rooftop unit replacement, what they mean.
Yeah, but it's a, like Jim, when we talked to Jim, it's a rooftop put on the ground. It's the same unit.
It's a rooftop that's mounted on a foundation of the ground. Yeah. There's a slab.
Really odd floor. Words.
I guess my only thing is, you know, we have Custom Sheet Metal. They've got the furnace here, they've got the furnace in Nelson Street, they've got the rec center. And I don't know if this is the same brand or the same same type of setup.
Well, we can pull the paperwork on the current furnace if you want. Take it to the Building and Grounds. And
yeah, the two that were installed here, when was that, last fall? I don't remember what brand those were. Or the one that was installed at Nelson Street office building. But, yeah, we can pull those.
Well, then we would want a motion to refer to the Building and Grounds for recommendation.
Well, if that's your choice, if that's what you'd like to do, if you're more comfortable doing that, then making a motion for one of these, that's certainly fine. I don't think we need to get these installed immediately. And I forget what the turnaround time was on orders. Lead time unit,
2 to 4 days.
2 to 4 days from custom. And O'Brien's, I know it said there somewhere, I think. Maybe not.
There's the rooftop, Brian said rooftop unit too.
Yeah.
So,
but, oh, yeah.
That was that one. Is there a possibility to get a third bid? Premier?
Premier's in the township too.
Yeah. Logan was was getting bids on these, wasn't he?
Yeah, these are the bids he's got.
Yeah. Did he, do you know if he contacted Premier Jim or anyone else?
I don't know. I was gone when he was doing this, and I know that these are the two for sure. I don't know that he, if he contacted Premier or not.
Okay.
I think the terminology that may be concerning you is it's a rooftop unit. It is a rooftop unit.
Yeah.
I mean, they can go on the roof, but this particular unit, they're replacing the unit that's there, and it's a rooftop unit.
Yeah.
It's just mounted, instead of mounting on the roof, they're mounting on a stand on the roof. They're mounting it onto a cement foundation on the ground.
Yeah, it's about me.
And I don't know what the
puzzle that they go on the roof and it's not there.
Yeah, I don't know what the difference between a rooftop unit would be and a unit like we have in the
basement. The atmosphere.
Yeah.
Where our furnace is here or inside.
That's the only difference?
It probably got a sealed. It's a sealed unit. It's a sealed unit because it's on the outside of the building.
Right.
Where a furnace like you have in here is in the basement, so it's not, right, doesn't have to deal with the elements.
They could make it clearer by saying an outdoor installed furnace. Okay, what would you like to do? Seek more bids, refer it to Buildings and Grounds for recommendation, or make a decision?
I'd make a motion to request one more bid from Premier and then give it to the Grounds Committee and let them make the recommendation.
I would second that.
Okay, we have a motion by Cruz, support by Ball, to request another bid for furnace installation from Premier, and then refer all three bids to the Buildings and Grounds Committee.
I would, for just general comment on that, I would like to have whoever is doing it contact both of these parties again for a rebid, only because Premier now knows what these bids are, and if he goes lower, it's not fair to either of these guys. So it should be a rebid on all three parties if we're doing three parties.
Okay.
I know it happens.
Yeah. No.
It would be fair with these guys.
Yeah.
That's it's for another bid.
It's then it won't happen at this week's Buildings and Grounds meeting. It'll have to be next month's. I doubt they'll.
How would it appear to them if they watched the TV?
Well,
it
certainly could.
It's public knowledge.
Yeah.
Anybody can get this.
Yeah.
Did you want the bid sealed in lieu of having an open bid like this?
I think that's a good idea.
I guess we'd want to tell both of these parties that we're rebidding with, we're looking for a third bid, and to be fair to everybody.
Yeah, because I think that there's a 30, the bid, this quote, this particular quote, I think is good for 30 days, so
right.
I'm not going to fall within that time frame.
I'm just trying to be fair with
you. Right, absolutely. Yeah. I didn't see what customs was, but I did see O'Brien's bid was good for 30 days, so getting three bids on those sealed would probably be the way to go. And seek another bid from Premier or anyone else.
And if they don't bid, then we can accept these here. I just.
Okay, so we have a motion on the floor. Everybody clear on the motion?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. Item D is consideration of approval of Charter Township of Filer Township Principal Residence Exemption Denial Interest Summary Policy, and that's what Sharon spoke to us about. You have that policy in front of you.
Make a motion to accept the policy as explained and written.
I'll second.
Motion by Brian Cruz, support by Kalinowski, to approve the principal residence exemption policy, denial interest summary policy as presented by Sharon and as spelled out. Any discussion? Sure, you want to call the roll then, please?
Cruz?
Yes.
Walker?
Yes.
Kalinowski?
Yes.
Paczynski?
Yes.
Wall?
Okay, and then we have the addendum item, consideration of approval of the sewer project draw, draw number four in the amount of $237,000.
Draw number four.
Draw number four. And you have the summary sheet of that draw in front of you. Support by Brian Cruz to approve the sewer project draw number four in the amount of $237,000. Any discussion? Shirley, you want to call the roll, please?
Ball? Yes. Paczynski?
Yes.
Kalinowski?
Yes.
Walker?
Yes.
Cruz?
Yes.
Public comment.
Happy warm weather. Amen.
Did Scott and the guys start the brush collection yesterday?
No, isn't that till the 7th?
What is today?
The 8th, I thought.
First. Oh, I thought the 7th.
Yeah, I was thinking it was the first week. It's the first full week, yeah. So. And I don't recall the word.
I see some stuff already.
Did it start yet then?
They're planning on starting Monday or Tuesday.
I thought it's next week.
Yeah.
Whatever Monday is.
Monday is the 7th.
7th.
I mean, that's what I think it was in the paper.
Yeah, the first full week of May. Yeah. Today's only the first, so. Anything else? Okay. Any other business to come before the board tonight? Dale, do you have anything?
No.
Shirley?
I do not.
Brian?
No, we don't.
Tom?
Nothing.
Okay. And I have nothing either. Any other motion for adjournment?
Second.
Support?